KitKat's not doing very well, huh?
No, the candy bar is. They're really good. Android KitKat, on the other hand, isn't really doing great at all. It's not even making the race.
Really?
The latest Android OS, or operating system, I should say, right. Version 4.4, which is nicknamed KitKat,
right.
It's not adopting at all. As of the end of this, or the end of April, they only had 8.5% out of all Android devices in the world. Only 8.5% have the newest operating system of the Android operating system. And there's not much theory why, other than Google's method of how they release the operating systems. That's a big possibility of what to put on blame. They're not like Apple, where Apple does everything they can to it's an open release to every device that can possibly run it.
Okay.
Android, and that's where Apple has a huge advantage. They make their own devices. They can tool them to work with the operating system and tool the operating system to work with the devices.
Right.
Android is an open source tile system, which means several manufacturers make the phone or the tablet.
All right.
So they all have different specifications. That's a huge player. And the newest system, the operating system, KitKat, requires more power, of which a lot of Android devices can't handle well. They don't allow it to release to those devices.
Right.
The most popular version is still Jelly Bean, which is the first one, or the last one prior to KitKat. All the subversions of Jelly Bean, it's 61% of the entire Android system. And Gingerbread, the next latest one, or earliest one, is, it's 3 years old, and it still holds 15% of the market. So there's an operating system 3 years old that holds nearly double what the newest operating system holds. And in comparison to that, with Android, KitKat being the newest, iOS 7 for Apple is the newest.
All right.
Like I said, 8.5% for KitKat. Over 80% is on iOS 7 for the Apple devices. So you see a major difference on how they release things, and it's such a mess. It's hard to put a blame on where it really is a problem.
But it could be you say it could be because the amount of resources that it takes to make it run on this device is reason some people aren't going for it or what?
That was the consensus on most of the documents I came across of minor statements Google would make, was that it simply won't work on a lot of these devices, so they don't release it to those devices. And people really can't put a theory on its control method like they used to say about Apple, because they don't make the device.
Yeah. Yeah.
Samsung, Nokia, well, it was Nokia, LG, all these different devices are made for one operating system. So if they don't make it up to par to follow up, I mean, there's even 1% still on the very first system ever released.
No kidding.
Yeah.
No kidding.
Wow. So they really, Google's got to clean that up. I don't know how to put it.
Well, I'd like to have it because I guess it's a little more secure than the earlier versions. That's correct?
Right.
It's more secure than the earlier systems. And with today's environment, you want as secure an environment on your mobile device as you can possibly have. And I'm not going to get it on my Samsung Galaxy Note 2. I don't think KitKat's going to come out to me. And the only way I could get that would be upgrade to another newer device, and maybe that's part of it too. Maybe people aren't upgrading as quickly as they used to because of the cost. Do you think that's a possibility?
That's very possible too.
Yeah.
However, that didn't really happen with the Apple market, so it's hard to really make that a plausible evidence.
Okay. All right.
I mean, for the carriers, they have changed their eligibility rules. Most of them used to be 20 months. For their two-year contract is when you're eligible. Now most of them are the full 2 years.
Yep.
But that didn't change much for most people.
Right.
That's still, Apple still holds strong with their upgrade, or their updated device process. people still adapt to it as fast as it comes out.
No kidding.
Well, but, and I think Android does too, is just there's too many devices. It's too inconsistent.
Okay. Well, if you hear any more about that, you got any questions this week, man?
I have not. From my old email address, and I say that because I don't know if I told you. So I'm sure my lower third's been wrong because I didn't mention it.
Okay.
I have a new email address since, you know, I do have the website, rodneyconnor.com.
Okay.
It only makes sense that I have an email through there.
Yeah.
Specifically for the show, it's rodney@rodneyconnor.com. Send me anything there, and, please, you know, tell people, do something. We're on show number 11 here, guys.
Yeah, we're rolling, man. We're on show number 12.
Oh, sure. Yeah, 12. Sorry.
Next show is going to be number 14. I'm not going to do a 13.
Yeah.
I didn't get a question per se based on our show. I did get a question on using vMix titles. And it seemed like they said they had a small TV station out in Los Angeles.
Uh-huh.
And he was able to use the vMix titles when he did recordings without any issues. But when he went to his live TV, then they weren't working. And that just didn't make a lot of sense to me why they weren't working. And so I did a small video, and I put that up on YouTube, and I'll put a link to that, about using the titles with vMix. And perhaps
right.
If somebody else is having that problem, that maybe would be some help to them. But again, they said they had a small TV station out there in Los Angeles and was having a lot of problems with vMix titles. And vMix is such a robust program. There's so many different things you can do with it. It's even it's got audio settings that you can set up, you know, specifically for different audio coming in, like your audio and my audio. You said, but it's also got audio compressor that you can compress the audio with, and just again, so many other things you can do with vMix, like the live tweets we talked about a while back. You can
right.
have live social media coming into your show. If you want to set that up, so you're getting ready to hit the bricks tonight, huh?
Yeah, I am. I'm gonna attempt to get in a power nap before, but gotta head in at 6 p.m. So
okay,
it's gonna be interesting.
All right, we've got our 20-minute show down to 48 minutes now.
Hey, we're getting there.
We're getting there.
Kind of,
huh? All right, man. I really appreciate you taking time and working us into your busy schedule today. Rodney, our next show is May 15th, 2014, and should I call it 13 or 14?
Well,
are you superstitious?
You know, I think we'll be safe. We'll just never mention the word 13 or the number 13.
All right, okay. Well, it'll be show number.
We'll see. Whichever one shows up is the one we did.
Okay,
that's all I can say.
All right, we'll pick a number then. But our next show is, again, May 15th, 2014, and Rodney Connor and I will see you again there. And you can watch this show on YouTube and let us know what you think. Again, if you got any comments or anything about what we've said, good or bad, I guess, drop a comment
please,
down below.
Please, anything. And... you can even tell me I suck. Just send me something. Yeah. I haven't even got that.
Yeah, just let us know what we could do better. We'd appreciate that. But we'll be back again on May the 15th. All right, Rodney, really appreciate it, man.
Hey, no problem. Glad to be on here again. Send questions to Rodney Connor, rodney@rodneyconnor.com or @rdconnor88 on Twitter.
That should be easy enough, shouldn't it?
Sure.
All right, man. Until next time. And when are you going to have the studio rolling, you say?
Well, we move on the 21st.
Okay. And just about a week after that, you're going to be in your new studio then, huh?
Hopefully so.
Okay. All right. Later. Have a good one.
We'll see you.
Thanks a lot, Rodney. Bye-bye.